Hello students, welcome to physics class. Today we discuss another application of dimensional analysis, that is to check the dimensional consistency of an equation. We already discussed one application, how to convert one system of unit into another system of unit. Now let us see how to check the consistency, the dimensional consistency of a equation by using the concept of dimension analysis. To check the consistency of this equation, we are using the principle of homogeneity of dimension. Let us see what is the principle of homogeneity of dimension. By the principle of homogeneity of dimension, a physical equation will be dimensionally correct if the dimensions of all the terms occurring on both sides of the equations are same. Usually, we can add or subtract the physical quantity having the same dimensions or same unit. So, in an equation, if all the terms on both sides of the equation having the same dimensions, then that equation is dimensionally correct. That is actually our principle of homogeneity. That is, a physical equation will be dimensionally correct if the dimensions of all the terms occurring on both sides of the equations are same. Let us see an example. Here, we have an equation S is equal to ut plus half at square. It's an equation in motion. The position time relation. If an object is moving with a uniform acceleration a, the position of the object after a time t is given by this equation. S is equal to ut plus half at square. S is the position or displacement of the object after a time t. If its initial velocity is u and acceleration is a, S is equal to ut plus half at square. Now let us check the consistency of this equation. On the left side, we have a term S that represents the displacement. On the right side, we have two terms. One is u into t and the other one half at square. By homogeneity principle, all the terms should have the same dimension. On the left side, we have a term S that is actually the displacement. So it is actually length. S, the dimension of the left hand side. The term on the left hand side, that is S, displacement. So displacement is actually a length measurement. So this term having a dimension L. Now on the right hand side, the first term is U into T. We told U is the initial velocity and T is the time. So what is the dimension of u into t? U into t. The dimension of u into t. U is velocity, lt raised to minus 1. And t is the time, so capital T. Lt raised to minus 1 into capital T. So that's also L. Now, the second term is half at square. No, half is a number, no dimension. So at square, at square, a is acceleration. Acceleration dimension is L t raised to minus 2 into t square. T is the time. So t raised to 2. So t raised to minus 2 and t raised to 2 getting cancelled. So it is also L. So both the term on the right hand side having same dimension. Also the term on the left hand side is also having same dimension. So the equation is dimensionally correct. We cannot say the equation is correct, but we using the word, the equation is dimensionally correct. So we check the consistency, dimensional consistency of these equations. Okay, now see another example. V is equal to u plus at. V is equal to u plus at. This is another equation of motion. The first equation of motion. What are the term? V is the final velocity of an object moving with an initial velocity u and acceleration a. After a time t, this velocity become v. V equal to u plus at. V, final velocity, u, initial velocity, a, acceleration, and t is the time. Now check the dimensions of all terms. On the left hand side, we have a single term, that's v. On the right hand side, two terms are the u and a into t. So first, let's see the dimension of v. V is final velocity. So the dimension of velocity is lt raised to minus 1. Now on the right side, there are two terms. First is u. U, initial velocity, lt raised to minus 1. The second term, a into t, a into t. So a into t, that's lt raised to minus 2. Acceleration, a, lt raised to minus 2 into t. So it becomes lt raised to minus 1, t raised to minus 2, and t raised to 1 become t raised to minus 1. So lt raised to minus 1. Here also, all the terms in this equation, both the left side and right side, having same dimension. So this equation is also dimensionally correct. Now let us see some more example. Here we want to check the dimensional consistency of the equation. Half mv square is equal to mgh. Here m is the mass of the object and v is the velocity of the object. G is the acceleration due to gravity. H is the height of the object. Actually, this term, the right side, this is the potential energy of the object and this is the kinetic energy of the object. Half mv square is equal to mgh. Now check the consistency. The term on the left side is half mv square. So half have no dimension. So mv square, m mass and v is the velocity. So m, the dimension of mass is capital M, into dimension of velocity square. You know, velocity is actually lt raised to minus 1. So that square of lt raised to minus 1, that is l raised to 2, t raised to minus 2. That is, we are finding the square of lt raised to minus 1 square. That's equal to l raised to 2, t raised to minus 2. That's l raised to 2, t raised to minus 2. So we can rewrite as m l raised to 2, t raised to minus 2. Actually, no, it is the dimension of energy. It's a kinetic energy equation. So this is the dimension of energy actually. Now on the right side, one term, that is mgh. No, it is potential energy actually. So m, the dimension of mass, capital M. The dimension of g, what is g? Acceleration due to gravity. So g, lt raised to minus 2, lt raised to minus 2. Acceleration. Into height, so it is also length, L. So if you are multiplying m, l raised to 2, l into l, l raised to 2, t raised to minus 2. So on the left hand side and right hand side having same dimension, so this equation is also dimensionally correct. Now see another equation, f into s is equal to half mv square minus half mv square, half mu square. Let us see what are the symbol here. F is the force acting on a body. S is the displacement for that body. This is actually that concept. Suppose we have a body of mass m acted by a force f, and if the object is displaced by a distance or displacement s. So F into S is actually the work done on the object. F into S is equal to half mv square minus half mu square. This is the change in kinetic energy of the object. Half into m, mass of the object, v, velocity, final velocity of the object, u is the initial velocity of the object. These are the simple F, force acting on the object, S is the displacement, m is the mass, v is the final velocity, and u is the initial velocity. So let's check the dimensions of all this term. Left side f into s, left side f into s. The dimension of f into s is, what is f? F is the force. So m l t raised to minus 2 into, what is s? Displacement here. displacement. So displacement is actually length, so into L. M L raised to 2, T raised to minus 2. That's M. L into L become L raised to 2, T raised to minus 2. So M L raised to 2, T raised to minus 2. That's the dimension of the term in the left side. But on the right side, we have two terms, half mb square and half mu square. Let's see the dimension of the first term, mv square. We told half is a dimensionless constant, so no need to write that. Mv square, m into mass, m into v square. We told what is v? Velocity, lt raised to minus 1. The square of lt raised to minus 1. That is l square t raised to minus 2. So we're getting m l raised to 2 t raised to minus 2. Multiply that. So third term, half mu square. Half is a dimensionless constant. So mu square. M is mass, capital M. U square, initial velocity square. Velocity square, l square t raised to minus 2. So it one m l raised to 2 t raised to minus 2. Now all these three terms having same dimension. So this equation is also dimensionally correct. Okay. Now see the another term, another equation, lambda is equal to h by mv. Lambda is equal to h by mv. Here, lambda is the wavelength. Lambda is the wavelength of a particle. H is Planck's constant. It's a dimensional constant, Planck's constant. Mv, mass into velocity. Momentum, actually m into v is the momentum of object. So actually this equation is known as de Broglie wavelength, de Broglie wave equation. The de Broglie wavelength, lambda is equal to h by mv. When a particle is moving, it having a velocity. If the mv is the momentum of that particle, its velocity can be right, sorry, its wavelength can be right as lambda is equal to h by mv. Lambda is equal to h by mv. So lambda is actually the wavelength only. Lambda is the wavelength of that particle. So the dimension of lambda is L, wavelength. And the dimension on the right hand side, we have h by mv. As it is a division, we can treat it one as a single term. That's h by mv is the term. Okay, it's a division. We can divide any physical quantities. Okay, so h by mv. So what is the dimension of h by mv? H, Planck's constant. We already derived the dimension of Planck's constant. That is m l raised to 2 t raised to minus 1. M l raised to 2 t raised to minus 1. And mv, mass into velocity. Mass into velocity. M l t raised to minus 1. So we're getting m l raised to 2 t raised to minus 1 divided by m l t raised to minus 1. So m and m getting cancelled. T raised to minus 1 and t raised to minus 1 cancelled. L raised to 2 divided by L. So on the right side is also L. Left side and right side having same dimension. So this equation is also dimensionally correct. So by using this principle of homogeneity, we check in the dimensional consistency of an equation. If the equation is dimensionally correct, all the terms on the left side and right side should have same dimensions. That principle is known as the homogeneity principle of dimensions. That's all today.